Thank you, Madam Speaker, and I thank the gentleman from Georgia for yielding me time to address this issue. I understand and recognize the gravity of this issue that's before us. I can hear it in the voice of the gentleman from Georgia. I can hear it from Mr. Clyburn. I can hear it from Mr. Nadler. And I know all of you. And I think I know all of you well. I thought you all knew me well. But I began to read this resolution, Madam Speaker, and I started with the first whereas, and I'm going to read it as it's here. Whereas, on January 10th, 2019, Representative Steve King was quoted as asking, quote, white nationalists, white supremacists, Western civilization, there's a dash in there, a pause. How did that language become offensive? Close quote. I understand how you interpreted my words when you read them this way. There is no tape for this interview that I did. It was 56 minutes long. There are some notes on the other end, but there is no tape. There's no way to go back and listen. But I can tell you this. That ideology never shows up in my head. I don't know how it could possibly come out of my mouth. So I'm going to tell you that the words are likely what I said, but I want to read it to you the way I believe I said it. And that's this. White nationalist, white supremacist, Western civilization. How did that language become offensive? Why did I sit in classes teaching me about the merits of our history and civilization? That's the end of the quote. Just to watch Western civilization become a derogatory term in political discourse today. That's what I believe happened. And it's 13 words, ironically, that's caused this firestorm. And again, I regret that we are in this place. I read all the rest of the resolutions that are here. Number two, I reject the ideology. The statement's true, Mr. Clyburn. Number three, same story. I reject the ideology that's noted in here, but your statement's true. As I read these so far down, number four, number five, all the way through all these resolutions, all the whereases that are here in this resolution, I agree with all of them. I agree with every word that you've put in this. It's an honest and a direct resolution put together to address a subject that has been too long before the public dialogue in this country. And when I look down at the resolve, that's usually the meat of these, it says resolved that the House of Representatives once again rejects white nationalism and white supremacy as hateful expressions of intolerance that are contradictory to the values that define the people of the United States. Well, I agree with that. Just a couple of weeks ago, I stood on this floor with a Bible in my hand, and I took an oath to support and defend the Constitution of the United States. That Bible wasn't just a regular Bible picked up somewhere. That was the shirt pocket size leather Bible that my great uncle John Richardson carried in his shirt pocket for 3 years in the Civil War. I come from a family of abolitionists. Maybe I would have some artifacts from his cousin, my five times great grandfather, if he hadn't been killed in that conflict. This means something to me. The abolitionism that goes clear back into my family, and they paid a price with their lives to make sure that all men and now all women are created equal and were endowed by our Creator with certain unalienable rights. And those rights are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And I absolutely believe in that. It is in my heart and my soul, and it's in my works. By their fruits you shall know them. But the New York Times has a different version of this. They make a habit of attacking the president, as a matter of fact. And I look at this language that's here, this resolution, that the House of Representatives once again rejects white nationalism and white supremacy and hateful expressions of intolerance that are contradictory to the values that define the people of the United States. I agree with that language, I've said. But I would add to it the language that I used on this floor in this very place last Friday afternoon when I said I would strengthen it by adding my previous statements, which not only correctly rejects white nationalism and white supremacy as evil ideologies, but also condemn anyone that supports this evil and bigoted ideology that saw in its ultimate expression the systematic murder of 6 million innocent Jewish lives. That's where I stand. That's what I believe. So I want to compliment the gentleman from South Carolina for bringing this resolution. And I've carefully studied every word in this resolution, And even though I'd add some more that are stronger language, I agree with the language in it. So I want to ask my colleagues on both sides of the aisle, let's vote for this resolution. I'm putting up a yes on the board here because what you say here is right and it's true and it's just. And so is what I have stated here on the floor of the House of Representatives. Thank you, Madam Speaker. And I yield back the balance of my time.
The gentleman from Georgia reserves. The gentleman from New York is recognized.